Hi, I'm Alexander K, and welcome to the 5th episode in our rundown of Japanese history in War Thunder. Today I will be looking at the A5 M4. The Type 96 carrier-based fighter is the official designation for the A5M, codenamed Claw by the Allies. Here in War Thunder, we have the 4th variant of this carrier-based fighter. This has the more powerful Nakajima Kotobuki 41 engine that produces 785 horsepower. Designed with two Type 89 machine guns, these are the same ones found in the Pi 57. On the whole, these aircraft are actually quite comparable. They're both pretty movable, not especially fast or well armed. However, the 2 A5M is the more movable. I'm just staring at the weird sort of rave lighting I have in the cockpit at the moment. A little unusual. As I was saying, the A5M is a slightly slower but more maneuverable of the two aircraft. It entered service with the Japanese Navy in 1937 as their first monoplane fighter, and performed well against its contemporary American and Soviet built aircraft flown by the Chinese Nationalist Air Force. By the time the war in Pacific started, the A5M had been replaced in frontline service by the famous A6M0. However, the A5M remained in service on some of carriers. I think it's on. I can't remember the name of the carrier. It did serve in the Battle of the Coral Sea, I think. Alongside the famous Zero. This is because obviously it took a while for the Zero to enter production and actually production to pick up to fully replace the A5M by the time the war started. It continued to see service throughout the war in second line roles, and eventually, towards the end of the war, saw service as many obsolete Japanese airframes did, as a kamikaze bomber. Right, with that brief little introduction to the history of the A5M, which I actually quite like as a fighter, I'll get onto the combat. Again, as with the Pi-27, you don't want to rush straight into combat. There are things you need to be wary of. Namely, I think, things like the I-15 and the Chaika. Those little Russian biplanes are probably the worst enemy. They're one of the few things that is more movable than you. And they also have pretty good firepower and can surprise you with their speed, although you can outdive them, which is quite nice. The biggest asset the A5M has is maneuverability, which I will hopefully show you here. You can use it against many enemy planes which think they are maneuverable, but in fact are nothing in comparison to Japanese aircraft. I'm looking at that Hurricane over there. Yes, the Hurricane is a maneuverable aircraft, but they just can't cut it against most Japanese aircraft. They are insanely maneuverable. So here I'm just going to sign and turn on and drop in on this Hurricane. Fire a few rounds of my god-awful accuracy. And you can see plenty of sparks across the airframe, giving me a hit of this nature, those Type 89s, although I get a nice fire there and knock out the Hurricane. So I roll over and look at my next target, which is going to be this second lone Hurricane. This guy proves to be a little more sensible than the first one. So again, pretty much the same manoeuvre. Move up to the side of the Hurricane and then attempt to drop in on a 6. This guy, I think he's going to be stupid and attempt to dodge fight me. I get a few hits in, but I see he was actually just diving away. I roll over to consider chasing him down, but at this point he's just a bit too far away, and the hurricane is faster than you, so I thought I'd turn back to the main engagement. I am going to keep looking back at that that hurricane as he turns around, he thinks I'm moving away, so I decide I'd head back in, have a look back at him. Keeping an eye on, make sure he's not gonna go straight up for me. Which he doesn't, he's not asleep, although it looks like he's going to here, and I get a few more shots in him, but again, my terrible shooting. Here you can see the excellent maneuver of the A5. Was that English? The excellent maneuverability of the A5 then. But it really lacks firepower. You can see it's got quite a nice both machine gun and mounted in the nose, quite close together, so you'd be pretty accurate with moving at range. So yeah, I got a critical insight to pull off the hurricane, but obviously the wasn't critical that badly, and it's just to fly away, so I'll leave it to it as there's plenty of more dangerous targets around. Mostly that I-15, which is still alive. So here I'm just picking my targets. Don't think I want to go for that hurricane. I'm mainly thinking of going for the I-15. So I decide to see if I can tempt him to come straight up at me. But I don't think he is, so I don't want to pick up too much speed. You can go over 500 kilometers an hour in this plane in the dive, but you don't want to push it too much. You will tear a wing off. I see this furious deciding to chase down the friendly Kate, but I see the hurricane I was chasing earlier pull up underneath me and going for this weird climb, so I decide to chase him down again. There I crit his cooling system, which I decide is enough damage, he's far enough away from his base. I decide that the damage to his cooling system will mean his engine seizes up before he gets back to base, so I leave him to it. As you can see, he's actually run out of coolant there, so I'm pretty sure he's dead, so I leave him and go after this Fury, which is still chasing our V5M2, although he has realised how close he is to our base and how dangerous that AA is. So, against biplanes, you really need to energy fight them. You don't want to have a biplane with energy over you, or for them to catch you at low altitude, because, well, basically, your main advantage is normally maneuverability, which is not the case against enemy biplanes. You want to use energy, which is what I need. Don't want to get energy trapped by them either, so I try and get an angle on this Fury. Get a couple of hits in there, basically just do a little bit of damage to his airframe, and he was pretty much stalling his aircraft to begin with. Not the best kill on my part there, but you know, a kill's a kill, I'm not going to complain. Here I'm stared in a gander, that's four enemies left. All of them are fighters, including that one I critted earlier. You see it's most of the work's been done by me and this BF-109 who's flying towards me being chased by an I-60. I'm telling him I'm going to engage the I-16. But he doesn't really, well, he is still being chased at this point. The I-16 is a somewhat dangerous opponent, however, given how maneuverable the I-16 is against most other opponents, it's not hard to try and get them to engage you in a maneuvering dogfight where you easily have the advantage. You are the more people playing. They are faster and better armed, so it's a good thing you can outmaneuver them. You do need to be fairly decent with your throttle control. You need to make sure you don't overshoot, because they can beat speed pretty quickly. However, throttling back and being able to stick on their six isn't too difficult. So here you can see I managed to get a few hits that the BF-109 knocked out his pilot, which is down to 180 rounds, and considering heading back to base, but I see the BF-109 is as he refuses my congratulations on the kill. So since the BF-109 is heading back to base, he's probably a little damaged, maybe out of ammo. I decide I will offer cover to his V5N2 Kate and just wait around for the BF-109 to get up since the base isn't that far away. So here I'm trying to see if I can see any enemies taking off from base, but no, still fine. So I'm just heading towards the Kate, offering a little bit of cover, just going to wait for the V4. And there's a nice light kill on that Hurricane I critted earlier. I was pretty sure he'd actually made it back to base, but so I'm just telling my team I think he's going to repair. And there's an I-16. I'm not reacting to him. I'm going to see if he's going to engage me first. I'm pulling my teammate. I'm going to attack him, but as you can see, he's not heading towards me at all. I think he is looking to win the game by destroying all of our ground targets. Only he's attacking our light tanks, which you can't damage with rifle caliber bullets. At least I don't think you can, unless he knows something I don't. So here I'm diving, I've throttled all the way back so I don't go too fast. Drop down on this I-16-6. Moves to the side, you see I overshoot. But if you do overshoot, there's no need to worry, you are more maneuverable, providing you don't rip your wings. It's quite easy hit. See, by this time, engaging a little bit of rolling scissors, I got the advantage. I'm now on his six, and he knows this, and you really should have gone up there. You should have kept low and just tried to outrun me. But I get a lucky fire, I decide to try and stick on him. But it matters, his wing falls off anyway, and I can see the final Hurricane has just taken off from its airfield. I notice that he is the last player on my team. I am down to 120 rounds, so I don't know why I'm bothering to tell my funding to prepare, so it's the last guy. It's me and this BF-109 against the Hurricane. It shouldn't be too difficult. My BF-109 is telling me to wait for him, so I'm okay with this. I doubt I'll get the kill. I've only got 130 rounds left, which I'm informing my BF-109 friend. So I'm going to be bait this time. So I look like a fairly easy target. I'm going to turn away from him since the BF-109 is still 4 kilometers away. Attempt to drag him a bit. I'm trying to look like a juicy target, not get too far away from him to draw me, to attack me, and then I'll duck underneath his guns when he eventually makes it, although he's not actually shooting at me, which I thought he might from this distance. As you can see here, he decides that it's time to engage the BF-109, so I go, oh, looks like I'm not going to be bait, and move to engage the Hurricane. Hopefully I can stay on his six and keep him maneuvering. Quite a few shots this way, just attempting to make him maneuver more, and he goes into this weird stall climb where I manage to get a fair bit of damage on. And then here I get a few lucky hits, and my last round manages to tear his ring off. So that is actually a nice, which is very nice. It's always nice getting an ace. Nice little banzai there for my victory. And turn back to base. See, this is a victory and an ace in the Ivy event. It's very much like the Kite 27. If you like that plane, you'll like this one. It's nippy, it's maneuverable. On the next episode, I'll be looking at the J1N1, the Navy's attempt at building a twin-engined fighter. So this has been the A5M. I'm Alexander the OK. Thank you for watching.